the data for the checkpoint inhibitors is a first step forward. You know, it really opened up the whole field of immunotherapy and immuno-oncology in gastric cancer. And so in that sense, it's a big leap forward. And now that we made this leap, we are sort of looking around and trying to understand how does it fit in to the other available treatments. What we're learning is that in gastric cancer, because it's such a heterogeneous disease, it's hard to move away from chemotherapy. The chemotherapy is still an important part of this algorithm. And there are subsets of patients in whom you could move away from chemo, and particularly in MSI patients. MSI tumors tend to be chemotherapy refractory, perhaps EBV subsets or hypermutated tumors. Yes, for those patients, immunotherapy is a life changer. And these are really groundbreaking responses that we see in life-changing responses. For the majority of patients, the benefit is very minor, and the responses are not as deep and not as durable. And so that's the point where we're regrouping. You know that pembrolizumab is FDA approved for MSI high tumors, irrespective of solid tumor origin. But for the majority of gastric cancers, it will be combination strategies that will hopefully bring chemotherapy and immunotherapy sort of on the same level of activity. So combination of immune checkpoint inhibition with anti-CTLA-4, anti-PD-1 blockade, other novel combinations of anti-PD-1 plus IDO inhibitors or LAG-3 inhibitors, and other inhibitors of small molecule inhibitors of tyrosine kinases and so on. So, but we're not there yet, and this is just emerging as research strategies.